Hi everyone, welcome to a new video. Today we're going to show you how to change your Wi-Fi name and also password to from default to customized. So you're gonna do this this is a 5G modem. So you can see this is the one for indoor, there's the one for outdoor, you know, so they are different, but they do the same thing. Almost the speed is the same, but this is just for out, for indoors. So you can see the 5G light is on, 4G light is off, and the, also the Wi-Fi, everything's fine. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna check the itself down here. You can see this is the IP, which is 192.168.8.1. so the Wi-Fi name is gonna be Huawei underscore h11 2 underscore f82. So this we're gonna change it, because anyone can come here and shoot a picture of this, then every time when it comes in, he goes and log in for free, so which we don't want. You can see the admin password, we changed that one, but now we're gonna change what we're gonna show you how to change from the default name to your favorite name. Also we're gonna change the password. You can see it gives you the password for the Wi-Fi, you can see. So which means if I take this, whoever takes this, he can log into my Wi-Fi for free. So this is what we want to eliminate, this is what we want to change. So this modem, it's I wanted to show you the model number, SIM only, it uses a SIM card. You can see the SIM card goes there. Okay, so this another one, the one for outdoor, it shows the model number. This one I don't see the model number, but it's fine, you can see it. So it's from Rain and Huawei, so I'm gonna do that. So now we're here, what we're gonna do, you log into one, you put in 192.168.8.1 okay. Then you can see this is 192.168.8.1. So once you put in that in your browser, make sure you are connected, then you hit enter on the keyboard. So it's gonna take you to the username and password to log in. Okay, once you're here, so already you put in the password, we're gonna just hit enter. The password is there. Okay, once you're in there, so now we're gonna click on your Wi-Fi settings. Okay, you can see how it is now. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna change the name, so also to the password we want. Let's click and delete that, delete the one, no app, no, that's the, this, you see this is the default password, we're gonna change it, and also we're gonna change the default name, this one. Can delete that and name it, we're gonna name that Wi-Fi, we're gonna name it, let's call it East London, one word. Okay, that's fine. So you can change the password to whatever you want. You can say East London at EA. Okay, no, delete that. Let's say at 123. It's London at 123. Just yes. After that, we save. You can see save. Okay, once we save this, we're gonna get disconnected very soon. So we're gonna get disconnected because that's not the same password we used here. So let me see, try to go to the internet and see. You can see we disconnected because that's not the name we have. So go back there, go to your Wi-Fi, we're gonna connect to the Wi-Fi again. Click on top here. So there where you were, wherever you, go back, yes, click there. So we're gonna choose that, select network, yes, we can go East London, yes, you can see it set, and we set it well on Wi-Fi, so it's gonna ask for the password. We can say East London at 123 connect. I'm gonna wait for them. Okay, you can see now we are connected to the new Wi-Fi we changed. So that's how you change, that's how you do what you, oh guys, you can, so you can see now how it worked. So the interface looks like this, you get me? So it's very easy to set. You can change your password, because the reason why you should do that is whenever you use one, this the default password, someone can come and shoot a picture of your modem, then that what happens, the person is gonna do what, is gonna use your password all the time, even giving his friends whenever he's in the area. Remember, this is a 5G, it's a little bit stronger, so even if you're far away, maybe at least 200 meters, you can access it. So maybe it could be your neighbor, it could be somebody else, and do this. So that's why I want, and also when you're creating a new username, don't create something predictable, like somebody can know like your name or whatever. Create something maybe which somebody cannot even think of, like you, it's you, you understand? So I created East London, but I'm gonna change it. This is something just to, for a test, and the modem has a lot of things here. Let me show you. So it has a lot of things here. You can, once you want to see you when you're setting up the password, you can click here so that you can see exactly what you're typing. If you don't want somebody to see, maybe you're setting it up with somebody sitting close to you, you can leave it like this. Now the bad thing about it, it doesn't have the second password verifier, whereby you're gonna type in the first password, then to verify it, type in the second password to see if it matches, then your password is correct. But here, when you are sitting alone, you can click here, then you can see what you're typing. But when you're sitting with somebody and you don't want him to know the password, you have to make sure what you're typing, you're gonna remember it. So if you don't remember it, simply means you're gonna do what, you're gonna repeat that password when the person is gone. But anyway, you can also leave it like this. Even if he's there, you will set it when he is gone also, if you don't want to share with nobody. So now if you want to switch off the Wi-Fi, you can switch it off here. So once you say okay, it simply means whoever connected to this Wi-Fi is gonna be disconnected. So which means your modem, you don't allow it to connect to Wi-Fi until when you reconnect it again. So for instance, I'm gonna say, if I say okay, so simply means we're gonna be disconnected. So to connect to this again, we won't be able to connect to it until we switch it on. And on this modem, you can see on this computer we're using a Wi-Fi, so it simply means we'll never ever also manage to switch on unless if we get a LAN cable. So we have to connect using a LAN cable to be able to connect to this Wi-Fi again, you get me? So if you want to switch it off, and you just say whenever I leave, I have to switch off my Wi-Fi but not switch off the modem. Whenever they see a modem but there's no Wi-Fi, so they get what they don't understand. Okay, yes, you see when you click on devices here, you have many you have what you have a chance to see whoever who's connected to this internet. You can see how many devices are connected here. So now you can see that most of these are phones, you can see. So whoever who was connected here, you can switch him off by clicking here. You know that that person will never connect to you again, because that is you banning this what this device to connect to your device again. So let me put it back. So you can see this is Android, simply means that is a phone there. Hisense, it was a Hisense phone. You can see SM, I don't know which one. So Huawei P8 Lite, there's a Huawei P8 Lite which is connected here. We can disconnect it. And iPhone. You can see a lot of things happening here. So you can say who's iPhone. I don't know iPhone, so I don't use iPhone. You can switch off this guy, and whenever, even if he gets a new password, you're banning this guy. You never connect to your Wi-Fi, you get me? So get all devices. You can see there are a lot of devices. Also, there's a computer here called PC 12. So also that, if you want to switch it off, you can. But you can see these are all the devices you are now, which are now connected. There's a PC, whatever, PC 6, Java. A lot of pieces are connected here. So this modem takes up until to 32 devices at the same time. So that simply means this modem is a little bit powerful than what you may think it is. So all these devices, it has proven that it can connect to all these devices. So we change the password now. We can take another step to ban those devices, whereby they will never ever connect to this modem anymore. Thanks guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video. This is Athania Tutorials.